7 years.
You know, all the different...
If genealogy excited me so much, I thought maybe it would be interesting to young people in the way that it was to me.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
And just to see the kids, the light in their eyes, I was so excited.
My dad's great-great-great grandfather.
And now we've created Finding Your Roots Camps. I want to share the news with everybody.
Hey, scientist?
Yeah.
Is that right, doing?
Good.
Game time. What does that mean when you say game time?
Time to
get it done. You know, in a few hours, you're gonna be revealing these things to some very special people, including your parents. I have had the privilege of being able to see how smart you are all week. The mentors that have been able to see how smart you are all week. Let's try to package this into a little presentation so you can communicate that with others. Mm-hmm. All right?
Is that good or bad?
Bad.
Okay.
I think that's good.
We're using all four films, then, I guess.
And then pop it in here.
I think that's enough.
No, that's a lot.
Well, we're entering the final day of the camp, and after all this hard work, now the campers are on the brink of the big reveal where they'll tell their parents what they found about themselves and what they've learned about science during this week.
So we'll put the iced coffee in here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
my
ear. And why don't you do the coffee?
Well, unfortunately, I found that I'm not related to President John Adams, but I am related to a lot of John Adamses and Samuel Adamses. There's a Samuel Adams here, there's a Samuel Adams here, there's a Samuel Adams here, and there's a Samuel Adams here. I found that pretty interesting.
My dog was easy to get because I had a treat and that made him drool. My cat wasn't the happiest, but she dealt with it.
Yep, so look under the microscope.
They might have inserted.
Do you see him?
I don't know. Wait, they died?
It's still alive.
It's still alive.
Stop shaking it.
That is a lot of DNA.
What?
That's a lot of DNA.
This is amazing.
How's everybody feeling?
Good.
It's been a hectic afternoon, right? There's been a lot of exciting experiments. And we're going to very, very shortly have a very special guest. Does anybody watch the show Finding Your Roots?
Oh, I know who's coming. I know who's coming.
Who's coming?
Me, Henry Louis Gates.
So,
I'm so excited.
Coming to Penn State this summer and actually being in that laboratory and feeling the fire within these children, sometimes I had to fight away tears.
Wow, hello everybody.
Hello.
God, I can't believe it. Are you having a good time?
Yes, of course.
Yeah? You learn anything?
Yeah, a lot. Learned a lot.
Like what? Tell me what you learned.
About DNA and who we are.
What's DNA?
DNA is the thing that makes up who we are.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I couldn't believe just the excitement of learning about DNA and about learning one's genealogy. And what's interesting, too, the stories that each one chose to tell.
You're between the ages of 10 and 13, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I first fell in love with what I later, only later, learned is called your family tree or your genealogy when I was 9. So what do you want to tell me? What did you learn?
My great-grandmother came from Czechoslovakia when she was 7 in 1927. And her mom was 27, and they came over, just the two of them. And imagine how hard that must have been.
Yeah, very lonely and scary.
It was really hard because my ancestors, they came from India as indentured laborers.
Mm-hmm.
And
they came where?
To Guyana.
To Guyana, right.
Yeah.
I would like to talk to you about an abolitionist in my
okay.
family.
Okay, all right.
He's my third great-grandfather.
And what's his name? Daniel?
Mann.
Daniel Mann.
He brought charges of assault against a person who wouldn't let a black man enter a train.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
And he treated William Lloyd Garrison, who was the father of abolitionists. He was a big deal. Wow, your grandfather's an important man, pulling William Lloyd Garrison's teeth with no anesthesia.
If you have a genealogical connection to an historical event, it makes it real and palpable. And even if one of your friends does.
Well, I wanted to talk to you about Marcus Garvey.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's part of my family.
No. The great Marcus Garvey.
Yes.
Father of black nationalism.
Yep.
That's how you relate to Marcus Garvey.
Well,
that means you're like Jamaican royalty.
Yes.
Oh, well, I like that. He goes, yes, I am.
I found out that he was my father's great, great grandmother's uncle, something like that.
Yeah.
I don't remember, but
yeah,
it was kind of confusing.
That's cool.
I remember that.
That's great. Well, Mr. Garvey, it's a pleasure. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
That's why I think the teachers can use this curriculum to change the way they teach not only STEM subjects, but social studies, more especially history.
You're the result of this dream that I had to bring genealogy and genetics to the American people. So I'm here just to say thank you. Thank you for fulfilling a dream I've had for a long time. So thank you very much.
On the last day of camp, when the parents came in, the kids were full of expectation.
We're gonna open the doors. People, your parents, your guardians, your friends, your family are gonna come, but you get a chance to tell them what I've learned from you all week. How does that sound?
Wonderful.
All right, is everybody ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's make it happen.
So at 2:30, they're letting families in to come and see what we've done.
So it's gonna be fun, great experience.
Kind of scared. For my individual project, I tried to set up my mom's family to, I think, my great-great-grandfather.
This is kiwi DNA. Our DNA is stringy, but fruits, it's like all like clumped up together. And this is
hair, dark hair or light hair, and newborn hair amount. And that one's funny because like I have so much baby hair.
The big reveal, the final presentations, they're lovely. And I like seeing how the adults in the room who didn't know that their kids or their kids' friends were capable of this are blown away.
What's up?
Diploid is two chromosomes from each.
To see young people teach others scientific concepts, genealogical concepts, through themselves and their story was unlike anything I've seen, and it was fascinating.
And this is my project.
Oh, yes.
I tested different kinds of coffees on the worms to see how differently they would react.
Okay.
The worms had a very good amount of DNA, and it was fuzzy and stringy.
Yeah, you can do you want to look at the worms?
Thank you.
Just look
up. Oh, wow.
We had worked hard to think about how all of these different ingredients of the curriculum might come together. And we knew that the kids would produce magic by themselves, but we didn't know quite how magical it would be.
I want you to take that excitement and work with courage and determination in the future. And I want you to go on, be energetic, happy, courageous, beautiful scientists. Thank you very much.
Kids love to study themselves. We can show you how you can bring the tools of finding your roots into your after-school program, summer camp, or classroom. Check out what happens when kids study their own DNA and family history by viewing our education programs and trying our research-based curriculum materials. For more information, visit us online.
Major support for Finding Your Roots, The Seedlings, has been provided by the Benkovic Family Foundation, with additional support from WETA, Public Television for Greater Washington, the Hutchins Center for African and African American Research at Harvard, and the following.
Thank you.